Hello everyone, welcome to Form Next. I'm Luis Rodriguez with Ultimaker. I'm pleased to welcome Emmanuel from Owens Corning. We asked you to here today to talk about the collaboration we've done recently with your materials and Cura, and just want to hear more about what you've been working on.
Okay, so so far we have been working for to develop new two filaments for 3D printing, so for FFF technology. So one is a polypropylene base with 30% glass fiber, and the other one is a polyamide 6, again with 30% glass fiber. So why did we develop this material? Clearly, Owens Corning is a leader in composite material, and we really wanted to leverage all the knowledge and competencies that we have in composite material and apply this knowledge to a 3D printing industry.
In what instances do you see using one or both of these materials, tools and fixtures? Or?
Yeah, exactly. The application, the final application is really for functional prototyping or industrial application. So we selected polypropylene and polyamide because these two metrics are the most used in injection molding.
Okay.
And our objective was to be able to propose to our customer and people that are using injection molding today an alternative in 3D printing, so they can start by doing a prototyping, a functional prototyping, before to enter into a mass production. And this is really what drives our development and why we selected these materials.
So the user can match as closely as possible to mold injection.
Exactly. That was our objective, to propose a product that is an engineering material with property that match the injection molding.
And what was the feeling behind collaborating with Ultimaker and our materials and Cura?
So what I really like in this collaboration is that 3D printing is not easy to adopt, I would say, in an industry. Mm-hmm. And so the value that I see with this collaboration is that you propose a printer that will be specially adapted to the material. So it's a way to accelerate the adoption, to have an easy experience and a better experience for the end user, because everything will be already populated in the setting. And this is the really the value of this collaboration with Ultimaker.
Right, we don't want engineers spending all their time trying to figure out how to print.
Exactly.
Your experts have already figured out, so they can get to
exactly.
Production.
And Cura proposed this parameter basis that will work directly. So you don't have to find or spend your time to optimize the printing parameter. It will work the first time.
Right. As soon as you install it from the marketplace, you're ready to go.
Yeah. Exactly.
So Owens Corning has Ultimakers in several locations. Can you tell us how you're using it and how you're using your own materials?
Sure. So we have two what we call high lab, innovation lab, that are dedicated to 3D printing. Mm-hmm. One is based, is located in Ohio, close to Columbus in Granville, and the other one in Chambéry, France, close to Lyon. And in both locations, we have an Ultimaker printer. We have a S5 for sure, we have Ultimaker 3 as well. So we are using X-Tron material for our own use. Can be used in manufacturing, in our operation plant, but also in our S&T center to support the R&D, the R&D work in general.
So who does the actual printing and output of the parts? Who does the training?
So we have experts internally.
Okay.
That are really specialized in 3D printing. We have one in the US, some people in Chambéry as well. And usually we receive some order from our plant. And now we have more and more order because they start to see the value of 3D printing. And usually they just send us a sketch on a piece of paper.
Okay.
And we closely work with them to redesign the part, to adapt it to 3D printing. And usually when we are doing that, they often came very quickly to another request. So that's nice to see that adoption can be very quick once you create awareness and when they see the value of this very strong material.
So you can iterate quickly across between the two continents, and then you will ship a file back and they will output the part?
Yeah, Exactly. And so I guess what we are seeing internally, it is exactly the same for external company. They are seeing more and more the value of this engineering material with higher performance, higher strength, and all this material can be used in high temperature application, much higher than the knit material itself, because the addition of fiberglass increased, of course, the modulus, the strength, but also the temperature usage.
That's great, thank you. You mentioned that you guys are working on future things. What areas are you exploring?
So we will release some new material early next year. There will be, we will focus more on high temperature polymer.
Okay.
More to come in 2019.
All right, great. Emmanuel, thank you for joining us and sharing what you've been working on, and we look forward to more in the future.
Thank you, Luis.
Thank you, everyone, for watching. If you want to find out more about using our products in office environment, please make sure to download the white paper.